Hey guys, and welcome to the Tantrum House Studio 3. I'm Will Meadows.
I'm Larry the Intern. Today we're looking at Gamma Grunts by Hipline Industries. I've always dreamed of smashing things, trying to dominate the world. And guess what, Will? We have all that right here.
Gamma Grunts from Hipline Industries is a deck building, deck smashing game, and they sent us a copy to check out, so we're gonna let you guys take a look right now. Gamma Grunts may look like a deck builder, but it's really a deck smasher for 2 to 4 players.
Each player is a scientist who's trying to be the last to go insane or be the first to 20 infamy points. Your starting deck is built with the Gamma Juice, Grunts, and Disruptions.
The rest of the cards are separated into piles based on how much they cost, 1 to 4 Gamma Juice. Your turn starts by resetting your cards and clearing the lab. This means that you reset your exhausted Grunts and replenish your Gamma Juice. Then, during your turn, each player can perform any of the following actions in any order. You can play cards from your hand, smash stuff, draft cards, or you can enter into combat.
In order to play cards, you have to pay the required juice price, then read the card for everyone else to hear. Drafting chaos involves, like Will said, smashing cards. You may draft up to 2 cards per turn as long as you can afford them. And in combat, you are sending your grunts out to do your dirty work. You can only attack 1 other player at a time, and you can't attack them multiple times.
If a player can't or determines not to defend, then he must pay the price with the cards from his hand or off the top of his deck. To determine the winner if he does dedicate cards, you compare the attack and defense values, and whoever has the higher number wins. The loser's cards are smashed, and the winner gains infamy.
After your turn is over, draw 5 cards to fill your hand. But if you can't, you lose. The game ends when all but 1 player can't draw 5 cards, or 1 player reaches 20 infamy first. So Will, what did you like about this game? Tell me.
Well, I enjoyed a lot of different things about it. It is technically a deck builder. You're drawing cards from your hand and you're playing those on your turn. You're also able to dedicate those cards in order to pull new cards from the store that you would have in a normal game, like a normal deck builder. But in this game, the Gamma Juice is interesting because you're paying for those cards every time and you kind of have to be strategic in that, because if you can't reshuffle your deck, which costs you a Gamma Juice, then you lose. And if you do, but you didn't do it quite right and you can only, you know, pull like 3 cards from your recycling bin, you're still out. So you got to be really smart about how you pay for cards, because that is your life force in the game.
You also have to think about when you send your grunts out, because if you send out 1 or 2 and the next turn around an opponent sends out 3, they're able to take advantage of the fact that you have grunts out there that are less and aren't going to be protected, so you actually will end up losing those grunts. They'll get smashed, they're out of your hand forever, which happened to me once.
It does feel really satisfying to destroy other people's grunts and kick them out of their hand. The artwork for the game is a lot of fun. Obviously, we've got a prototype, so there's a lot of prototype art in there and artwork pieces that are missing, but I really like the style, and I really just like the whole concept of, like, you're in your lab, you're pouring the Gamma Juice, you're making your grunts, you're sending them out into the field to attack other people. It's got a pretty cool feel to the game.
One nice aspect about this game is you can keep grunts protected in your lab and you don't send them out until you're ready. They can't be attacked, you can't use them, but they are protected in the lab. That is their safe space.
Right, but then you're very vulnerable, because if you do get attacked and you can't defend, you have to lose those cards either straight up from your hand or from your deck. So having something out there, if anything, will kind of reduce the risk of, like, oh, I'm just losing a 1 grunt instead of who knows what this card could be off the top of my deck.
The one thing that you really have to keep in mind is you have several different parts of this game in play at once. You have to watch out for other players attacking you. You have to put out your grunts to attack other players. You also, like Will was saying, you have to keep your Gamma Juice in check as well, because if you don't have enough to reshuffle and you don't do it at the right time, then you're done. That's it. And then you also have to keep in mind, all right, how many cards do I want to recycle to get a card of a certain value? So there's a lot of different things at play, and it looked really simple when we started, but I think we both agreed there's a lot more strategy involved.
Yeah, you jump into it thinking it's going to be really simple, and it's, you know, the artwork's a little cartoony, but there is a really decent amount of strategy into how you take your turns and what you do with it. This game is coming to Kickstarter really soon, so if it sounds like something you'd be interested in, then check out Gamma Grunts on Kickstarter, and then be sure to subscribe to our channel. We always love making movies for you guys to watch and hanging out together. Thanks so much for joining us. We'll catch you next time. You guys from Hipline I tried to sound all confident when I said Hipline.
Sure.
Prototype didn't work out. Okay. The defender can determine If a player determines, oh gosh.
Are you having a stroke?
Maybe, yeah.
I was having a stroke. Yeah. The first part I felt like we were